This video is going to talk about odd and even functions. An even function is defined as f of negative x is equal to f of x. And what that really means is if it's an even function, if I'm going to have the point x, y on my graph, I'm also going to have the point negative x, y. I have a negative x here, and the same, that's a positive y output. Let's look at the points first. I have the point 1, 0 here. And on my graph, I should have negative 1, 0 when I change the x sign. And I do. Now I look at my graph and I talk about symmetry. Do you look at this y-axis? If I were to put a mirror on this y-axis, then if I looked at this side of my graph, in my mirror would show up this side of my graph. They're mirror images or symmetrical about the y-axis. And that's going to be important. It has to be about the y-axis. I could have a graph that looked just like this, but if it moved over, it wouldn't be an even function because it would have caused me to not be symmetrical about the y-axis. So this is very important. Just because it's an even exponent doesn't mean it's an even function. Looking algebraically, we have our f of x up there as x to the fourth plus 2x squared minus 3. If I put in negative x, when I get done, I should get back to this exact same thing. But remember, this means put in negative x and then to the fourth plus 2 times negative x squared minus 3. Negatives to an even power will be positive, so that's x to the fourth plus 2x squared minus 3, which is my f of x. One other thing that we can talk about, and that is to talk about the exponents. If you notice, all exponents are equal to an even. And even if you think about this one, it would be x to the 0. Now 0 could be positive or negative, so it also is even in this case. So you have symmetrical about the y-axis, you have opposite signs on your x's, and you can prove that by just plugging in negative x to your function and getting the function back out. Or you can look at the function and see, are all my exponents even? Then it's going to be an even function. So let's move to odd functions. Odd functions say that if I put in negative x, I'm going to get the opposite of f of x. Or if I have an x, y, I'm going to have a negative x, negative y. So if I have 1 and 1.5, I should have, what that means is negative 1 and negative 1.5. Let's look and see if we do. Here's my, looks like, 1 and 1.5, and negative 1 down to negative 1.5, sure enough, there it is on my graph. So let's talk about the symmetry. The symmetry goes this way. It's about the origin. Those are a little bit harder to see, origin. But if you take your pencil on your paper and put it right there on the origin, and then turn your paper 180 degrees, you're going to end up with this exact same graph. All right, so the last thing we have to do then is look at it algebraically. So we have our f of negative x. This time, if we put in negative x, we should get in the exact opposite function. So we have negative x being cubed plus 0.5 times negative x. Or this is the negative being cubed, which will be a negative. So negative x cubed, 0.5 times a negative x will give me a negative 0.5x. And you notice that this is a negative and a negative. Both my signs are negative, and in my original problem, both my signs were positive. So the signs are opposite. So I know that it is going to be an odd function. And again, let's look at our exponents. Does the rule still apply? Yes, it does. All these exponents are equal to an odd number. That is odd and even functions.